not gonna front, bro. Like, if you wanna do this YouTube thing, you have to love it. It has to be, there's a red carpet doing it. It's a red carpet just like here. Apparently, this is behind the shop and there's a spot called Rain. And I cut the person who owns it. And he was telling me that like mad, like club promoters. And anyways, I'm just talking right now. But yeah, it's a lot harder than you would think, I guess. You have to have a purpose, you have to have a reason. And I guess this episode is telling you guys, see that breathing thing? This episode is telling you guys what exactly I did, what my thought process was behind YouTube. This is Ryan right here.
Hey, how's everyone?
Just gave him the fresh one. What do you think, Ryan?
Good cut, excellent cut. Highly recommend you. Hey. Highly recommend you.
Ryan came in, he wanted to get like, what did you come in with wanting? Like a fade, like for? And you hadn't been to a barber since like what?
Prior to coming to Kev, it's been a while. It's been a good while. About close to a year.
And you watch the YouTube, right?
Yes. I look at some of the barbers on YouTube and just to get an idea. And I saw you on YouTube and your documentaries.
Wonderful. Now you're in one.
Now I'm in one. I'm on YouTube.
Trust. Pick up the phone, show me it was real. Pick up the phone, show me it was real. Pick up the phone, show me it was real.
So we about to cut all this off.
Yeah. I don't want to put the pressure on.
Summertime, fine. That's what Mike said. He trying to be summertime, fine. How do
you? Can you start off higher than that and then I'll let you
Yeah, know. But then, so you're getting a fade around?
Nah, I'm going to just taper it.
Just taper it?
Yeah, I want to grow out the side.
So this is going to be darker than right here.
Yeah.
Okay.
Get the other lens. I'm trying to get like the background of the title along with the cut.
Oh, you gotta get real low then.
Right?
Yeah. Then do a vertical.
Like this?
Yeah. It's about hot as. Oh, shoot. I didn't even see you. Sorry. I didn't see you. You're good.
Don't like cut like up till it gets to here.
Okay.
And then the front just like.
So is it any different than we usually do it or what?
Not much. Just that I want the front like up to here so that it's not like all over the place, but it's not like I have like all my front hair gone.
What?
I put haircuts in like videos.
Can you put my haircut?
Yeah.
You put it on YouTube?
I'm going to.
What do I search up on YouTube?
I write it down for you. It's a barber suit.
Write it down for me what I search up. And then I want to see myself in the video.
Yeah. Set it all up.
Not all of it. I want
to
like.
What's the most game you've had on your head for some time?
Right here. Like right up to here.
Okay.
This one's for you. This one's for you. I think I made it. I think I made it.
You really know how to do this.
Yeah.
In practice.
A lot.
I'm not sure.
Well, I mean, with everybody who walks in, you practice. I try to go home and practice.
Are you
going to
give me like a first cut on the sides?
Yeah.
Again, like,
look like a new boy.
The whole
thing. Like, do you like the shop?
Yeah, I love it. You're really
good at this stuff. Thank you.
I have to. That's not how you
go at all.
Yeah. You should be a professional.
Professional? I am a professional.
No, I'm saying, like, you should be, like, working at New York or something.
Oh, where? Why
you said that? If you have a part-time, after you finish this job, you should like give haircuts to like LeBron James.
LeBron James?
Yeah. What's your dream? Your dream to be a famous haircut.
What's my dream?
Yeah, what?
My dream is to make you feel amazing.
To make you feel amazing?
You, everybody who comes in my chair. I don't care if it comes, you can't hear me because of them, right?
You don't care for what?
Cutting celebrities. I don't need to cut celebrities.
Would you like to cut LeBron James?
Yeah, that'd be dope. Yeah, you know, somebody who a lot of people would want to cut for me. That'd be cool.
You should get a cut yourself.
I do. I do need a cut. You can tell.
You should get a beard cut.
A beard cut? I don't know. You want a beard?
Yeah.
You do?
On a long beard. When I grow up, I have a beard like that.
Who's gonna take care of it? You gonna take care of it?
Yeah,
I'm gonna take care of it right now.
I'm gonna like put stuff in it, like stash food in it. Say.
Stash food.
Mhm.
That's a plan.
How does the buzzer cut?
How does it cut? I'll show you. You know how a scissor cuts?
Yeah.
So with a scissor, there's a moving blade, there's a still blade, and then it comes through and cuts. Right, with a clipper, there's a bunch of scissors. This is the moving blade.
I see, like.
So then you turn it on, it's a bunch of scissors that goes back and forth.
Yeah.
And then they cut.
But how does that thing cut with that on?
Oh, okay. So with this on, all this does, it makes it longer. Like when something passes through here, it gets cut. So when I put this on, it's further down. And then here, it's even further. See how far away it is now?
So like you could cut a lot
longer hair, exactly. Now you know how to cut hair, you should be a barber.
I'm gonna be a businessman. Yeah, I'm gonna have a part-time job as a geologist, try to find the largest diamond in the world.
Okay.
A diamond size in a store.
Where'd you hear about geologists?
I like to study rocks.
So what's your favorite rock?
By far magma.
A magma? I don't even know what that is.
It's from lava? The center of the earth. When a volcano blows up, I have magma. You need more pressure than you need to make synthetic diamonds.
No way.
That's a lot. The earth builds up pressure.
You're a smart kid.
Mm-hmm.
You're gonna use that, huh?
Mm-hmm. I am a smart kid.
Here in my crib, finishing up this edit. And I know a lot of you guys have questions about like YouTube and Instagram and what should I do as beginner barbers? What should I start? Like, I'm not good enough to start a YouTube. I'm not good enough to start an Instagram. I'm not good enough to do any of these things or even promote myself. Like, I don't even like my cuts. What should I do? Now, for those people, I'd advise you to start because for two interesting reasons. For one, being good on Instagram is different than being good in real life. Like being good at posting, being good at marketing, being good at any of that is separate from actually being a good barber. So you can develop both of those skills. One doesn't determine whether you can do the other. So as somebody who doesn't have the skill set to market themselves as a barber, you don't have to actually do that. You can literally just document your work. You can say, hey, like everything's about story. You gotta know what you're saying. That's why at the beginning of the video I said you gotta know why you're doing what you're doing. You can't just do it because people say you should. You have to have a reason. And when you have a reason, let that drive you. So when I started my YouTube, I was just documenting. I'm still just documenting, but my ultimate goal, I have a few goals. Like I wanna be an educator. I had a dream of owning my own shop. I don't know where that is now. I'm interested in maybe owning a school, but overall I just wanna inspire barbers to be more than what they currently think they can be, you know? And however that happens, is, you know, how it happens. I'm using my skills right now to try and use that, like film skills, my ability to speak and formulate thoughts and communicate with people, my music acumen, business acumen, just different things I try to use. All my skill set to try and drive that, you know, that message to people. I think it's important that you as an individual, you as a barber, see what skills you actually have, see what message you want to push and do that because nobody can do it like you. Nobody can do it like you. Don't look at the next man. Look at your skill set. Look at what you can develop and develop that. That's the best thing I can tell you as somebody starting, because people who do well on YouTube, people who do well on social media aren't people who are trying to do well. I think it's very misconstrued. What they're trying to do is communicate an authentic message. Sure, you'll have people who are clout chasers, who do things for views, do things just for that clout, right? But I think people know who those people are. You know what I'm saying? You can really tell the real from the fake. Like, for me, I love like an Andrew Does Hair on Instagram, or a Casey Neistat on YouTube, or, you know, these the different people kind of see their realness, even though clickbait doesn't mean you aren't real. It just means you understand human emotion and you understand interest and you use that to get your message across. But once I see your message and I see that it's authentic, then I stick around if I connect. You know, that's why you're watching this video up until this point. Like, I had a very long point with this kid. I was very, like, apprehensive if I was gonna put this in there, but I really liked the conversation. So if you're up until this point, comment down below and let me know that you know you've gotten this far, because I think it's really dope when you guys watch all of this. If you just watch at least half of the video, it's amazing. But watching up until here is dope too. But yeah, man, don't overthink. Don't overthink about posting. I think all the time that stops me from posting sometimes, like, will you guys like this? Will you guys learn? Is there a message in this? Like, you just bog yourself with, you know, just document. You know, at the end of the day, don't want to get too crazy, but you can die tomorrow. Once you die tomorrow, did you try everything you wanted to try? Did you do everything you wanted to do? Or did you allow the thoughts of others or the perception of others, you know, like, kind of cripple you? You don't want that to happen. You want to live in the most unadulterated free expression of yourself. That doesn't mean break the law. You know what I'm saying? That means don't let societies box you in into something that you aren't. You know, be you. And I think that's what's dope about the internet. That's what's dope about the videos. Dope about everything here. Everybody has the ability to be them. And if you don't get that from any of my videos, then I'm not doing my job. You know what I'm saying? Make sure that you know you can be you. And I'm going to continue being me. And we're going to push forward. All right, y'all. Hopefully you feel inspired. Hopefully you do more. Hopefully you do something today. Thanks for watching this video. See you in